Water level's going down. Looks like there's only one way out of here. Money. Thank you.
Edgar? Chest behind you!
Thank you. chance for the hand. But I had it under control.
Can tell.
I found the plan. The locals call it La Orquídea de la Vida, or something foreign like that. We get this back to Calico, squeeze it out, and maybe we have ourselves a way to turn this around.
I'm sorry I got you into this.
Yeah. Getting your ass out of the fire has kind of become a habit.
Edgar, you can't keep doing this forever.
When those ticks attacked the manor, what did your father do? Run? Nah. He kept on squeezing the trigger. That's what he did. People like us don't retire, Jesse. Even if you're lucky enough to live long enough, you'll soon realize there's nothing waiting for you. There is no normal for people like me or your father. And I was naive to think there might be some normal for you. Anyway, now that just about everyone else in the Institute is dead, I figure you and your daddy are gonna need all the help you can get to build things back up again.
Well, first you give me those pretty flowers, then you get all emotional on me. Edgar, you ain't gonna try to kiss me now, are you?
You little shit. Damn it. Harrow's here.
You backstabbing witch! You ratted us out!
Dr. Blackwell, I know we've had our differences, but this...
For your information, I had nothing to do with Mr. Harrow's sudden appearance on our doorstep. But thank you for confirming how little faith you have in me. Now, I don't presume to know how things work for you, gentlemen. But I can assure you that Calico wasn't built on broken words and betrayed confidences. Women in my position don't have that privilege. Now, I assume you have the plant?
We do.
Good. And there are clean syringes and alcohol swabs in the lab.
5 minutes is all we need.
Mr. Gravener's looking for you, sir. He's in the basement with your partner.
Mr. Jesse, good to see you back. Is Agent Gravener okay?
Grouchy as always.
What a relief. You were gone so...
Did you... Smart.
Come on, William.
I've seen you survive worse.
Feeling
that someone's squeezing my brain. There's some thoughts in here that aren't mine. Oh, I see her, Jesse. Oh no, you must stop her before. Wait, I see a sign. Dickinson, she's in Dickinson.
I need to get to Dickinson. Tough old bastard, he's turning it around on her.
It's gonna be a hard sell to Harrow.
Gotta try. You keep an eye on him. And keep your hands off that switch.
Mr. Harrow is waiting in the briefing room. He's being a...
Assistant Secretary Harrow, sir.
Agent Rentier. Dr. Blackwell brought me up to speed on your father.
Sir, we...
I know. It couldn't have been easy. His shadow will loom large over us all. Please accept my condolences on behalf of a grieving nation. Try not to wallow in grief. It only leads to blunder. And this country desperately needs success.
Aside from the news of your father's tragic demise, I've also briefed the Assistant Secretary on the successful destruction of Felicity's leech factory in McCallum Sawmill.
That and a penny will buy me a cup of warm piss, Doctor. No one is safe while that crazy she-beast and her army of freaks are on the loose. And do you have any idea where she is? No.
Actually, I do, sir. We have intel that she's currently in Dickinson.
What intel?
Can't say, but it's 100% solid.
Great. You can head for Dickinson after you get back from Kingston.
Kingston?
There's a case containing some very sensitive information there that I need picked up.
But sir, the Dickinson lead. There's at least 3 interstate railroads there. It might be a part of Felicity's transport.
Very well. You there. What's your name?
Oni? Virgil Oni?
Do you know your way to Kingston, only Virgil?
With all due respect, Mr. Assistant Secretary, Virgil is our top engineer. He is not fit for field action.
I don't give a watery shit about his curriculum fucking vitae, Doctor. I'm funding this circus of yours, and I want those papers back now.
I'll get them for you. What do I need to know?
We recently got our hands on a partial list of companies tied to the Andalusia Financial Services Group, like McCallum's Mill and the Kingston Oil Fields.
Debano.
Debano indeed. He and his maniacal brat are up to their assholes in illegal acquisitions, and the government intends to seize their not insubstantial portfolio.
Sounds like you need a lawyer, not a vampire hunter.
Tried that already. I even sent in the blasted National Guard to secure the papers. But the place was guarded.
That's where you come in.
So what exactly am I looking for?
Based on the final telegram from my forensic accountant, Andalusia's portfolio of holdings is stashed in a briefcase, presumably still at the Kingston Oilfields Bureau on the far side of the lake.
I still don't get why it's more urgent than looking for Felicity and Dickinson.
Wars cost money, Rentier. And unless you've forgotten the incident at your former headquarters, we are at war. This could very well turn the tides in our favor.
Let's get this over with.
You all right, folks? I need to find the office.
You crazy? The whole area's been totally overrun by bloodthirsty freaks.
The National Guard's fighting back, but there's too many of those monsters.
If they don't get some help soon, we're all goddamn doomed.
like that.
Money.
The National Guard flooded the fields, but my friends were stuck on the other side.
Thank you, stranger. We thought we were goners. Is there some way we can repay you?
Yeah, you can point me towards the oil company office.
Oh, it's on the other side of the lake. Though you're gonna have to drain it to get over there. Release all counterweights and you'll open the sluice gates.
Let's drain this sucker. Good. Need to get to that other one now.
I hope you make it, sir.
You sure it's safe for us to leave now?
Where's that switch?
We thought that was it for us.
Taking it.
Following Arrow's orders.
Time to get that briefcase and go.
Painful. bug. Is that it?
Hey! Who's there?
Cash.
Shit. For a second there, I thought you were one of those demons. The National Guard barricaded us inside here before they headed off to protect the company office. If you want to find the man in charge, you need to use that crane to move those crates.
Thank you.
Thanks for letting us out.
The office. Where is it? I need the man in charge.
There's no way to get there from here.
Unless you use the zip line from the top of that tower. But that'd be crazy.
Please, you gotta help my buddies. Once you get on the other side, just follow the pipes. It's a kind of maze, but just keep going.
So glad you made it, sir. God bless you, sir.
I can go see my family now.
After a closer examination, I believe these trust documents are suspect. Every 30 years, the property rights are transferred to the next generation. However, I believe that Peter DeBano has likely been deeding them to himself for who knows how many years. Sincerely yours, Jonathan Q. Biddle.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Christ, it's about time someone sent in the cavalry. I've been hiding here for a week.
This ain't a rescue mission, so watch your mouth. I'm here to pick up some documents for Assistant Secretary Harrow.
Documents? I don't know anything about any documents. Oh, these documents?
You must be the accountant.
Jonathan Q. Biddle, at your service. Mr. Harrow promised me immediate backup, as long as I kept this safe.
Harrow's written you off, Biddle. Sent me for the case, not you. All I know is that DC wants that portfolio seized.
DC? What an asshole. Harrow isn't trying to leverage this property for the government, you ape. He wants it for himself. He wrote me into this scheme for a cut of the profits, and now he's hung me out to dry. That asshole.
How big a cut?
10%.
Hope it was worth all those soldiers' lives, you greedy little pissworm. I'll take that.
Whoa, wait. What about me? How'll I get home?
Walk. Turning the tide's my ass. More like lining your own pockets, you slimy shit.
What the hell are you...
Biddle. Oopsie-daisy.
You sent 24 National Guardsmen to their deaths for a paycheck. When the president gets wind of this, you're a dead man.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's just that the way the veins in your forehead are throbbing, it's so comical.
Mr. Assistant Secretary, these accusations sound serious, and...
First of all, it's Mr. Secretary now, as in Secretary of War, as in the fucking right hand of God. Secondly, do you think the president of these United States is gonna give a royal fuck about the pissant accusations of a podunk? Go ahead, Rentier, do it. Give me a reason to throw your cowpoke ass into Newgate and flens your father's legacy to the bone. The Harrow Institute has a much better ring to it, don't you think?
Mr. Secretary, maybe it would be for the best if you...
Maybe it would be best if you stopped interrupting me, you groveling mule! You want to make yourself useful? Get to the kitchen and fetch me a cup of coffee! Now fuck off and find some vampires to kill. That's much more your speed. You want something done right?
I'm surprised voltage that high didn't...
Virgil and I were just having the most invigorating discussion.
I was telling Director Rentier about my ideas for upgrading the gauntlet.
I must say, it's refreshing to see young blood like Mr. Olney's coursing through Calico. We'll need his vital spirit if we're to rebuild the Institute's power and vigor. Well done, son.
I think we may have given him a few too many vaults.
Glad to see you're in good shape, but we've got a situation. In order to keep your condition quiet, Amelia told Harrow you died. He's pulled rank and is sending us out on money-grubbing errands while Felicity's building her army.
Harrow's head knows what's right, but his heart is tainted by lust for power and money.
It's gonna get worse now that he got promoted. One wrong move, and we're dead in the water.
The one right move, and you could catch her and end this war. On the subject of moving...
You know what? Maybe let's wait for the doc to give the all clear before we start unbinding anyone.
Oh, Edgar. Harrow's not an idiot. Without the Institute, this country would turn into a blood feast. Now, you tell me, son. What's more important? His approval or ending this war before it started?
What did you see while Felicity was in your head?
Death. Horrible monsters appearing out of nowhere. Fire, smoke, everything. And boxcars. Scores of them. Filled with blood.
That's how she's transporting the leeches now? By train?
That's not good, sirs. Dickinson is a major cattle railway hub. The trains run in all directions. If there's an outbreak, we won't be able to contain it.